Hello students, welcome to this video. In previous video we have seen management and control component of data warehouse. Okay, how the data warehouse is managed and controlled by this component or block. Okay, that we have already seen. Today we will look at the one important point, that is metadata in the data warehouse. Metadata is like a yellow pages. So what do you mean by yellow pages? These are like a directory where we get whatever information we want. Okay, आपल्याला जी काही information हवी असेल ती सगळी आपल्याला त्या yellow pages मध्ये मिळते. For example, समजा आपल्याला एखाद्या restaurant ची माहिती हवी असेल within that particular city, किंवा एखाद्या medical shop ची माहिती हवी असेल, तर सगळ्या वेगवेगळ्या type ची माहिती त्या येलो पेजेसमध्ये असते. सिमिलरली मेटाडेटा इज ॲक्ट ॲज अ येलो पेज इन द डेटा वेअरहाऊस. ओके, सो द मेटाडेटा कंपोनंट सर्व्ह ॲज अ डिरेक्टरी ऑर वी कॅन से येलो पेज ऑफ द कंटेंट्स ऑफ युअर डेटा वेअरहाऊस. डेटा वेअरहाऊसमध्ये काय काय स्टोअर केलेलं आहे, कशा प्रकारे स्टोअर केलेलं आहे, ही सगळी इन्फॉर्मेशन या मेटाडेटामध्ये असणार आहे. Now types of metadata. We can divide the metadata into three categories. First is the operational metadata, second is the extraction and transformation metadata, and third is the end user metadata. Okay, so first we'll talk about operational metadata. Okay, so this operational metadata contains the information regarding the source system. Okay, because data warehouse data comes from several operational system. These source system contain different data structures. The data element selected for the data warehouse have various field lengths and data types. In selecting data from source system for the data warehouse, we split records, combine parts of the record from different source file, and deal with multiple coding schemes and field length. So this information will be there in the metadata. Okay, when we deliver the information to the end user, we must be able to tie that back to the original source data set. Operational metadata contains all this information. Okay, so we must be able to track the data from source system to the information delivery. Okay, so that is the main job of metadata. Okay, and operational metadata contains this information. Next is the extraction and transformation metadata. So it contains data about the extraction of the data from the source systems, namely the extraction frequencies, extraction methods, and business rules for the data extraction. Also, this category of metadata contains information about all the data transformation that takes place in the data staging area. In simple terms, whatever transformation or we do, related information will be there in this type of metadata. Similarly, how we extract the metadata, at what frequencies, how we get that data metadata, which tools or technique we use, okay, and what are the business rules, okay, that all information will be there in the extraction and transformation metadata. And last one is end user metadata. So end user metadata is the navigational map of the data warehouse. It enables the end user to find information from the data warehouse. The end user metadata allows the end user to use their own business terminology and look for the information in those ways in which they normally think of business. Okay, so this is like a mapping. Okay, so this is also important from end user perspective. So these are the types of metadata. Now we'll look at why this metadata is so important. Okay, so first is it acts as a glue that connects all parts of the data warehouse. Okay, so it binds all the components together. Okay, also we have seen that for this management and control component to work properly, metadata plays important role. Next is it provides information about contents and structure to the developers, okay, so that they can develop their application easily. It opens the door to the end user and makes the content recognizable in their own terms. Okay, so these are the importance of the metadata. Okay, so thank you.